At this time, Miss Kenisha Palmer will introduce to you our MC for the morning.
Parents, teachers, and students. So today I'm going to take time out to welcome the director of Immaculate Modeling Agency, Mr. and Mrs. Jamaica High School, a father, an advisor, a teacher, a businessman, a one with a great sense of humor too. Ladies and gentlemen, let us give it up for Mr. Paul Abram.
Thank you very much. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Okay. Can I get a little better movements from it? So let me say it once again. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
All Portugal observe that. Let us big up some wonderful persons inside the place. Give a big round of applause for the chairman, Mr. Burke. Give him a big round of applause. Principal Diddy, give her a big round of applause. All the teachers, give them a big round of applause. Parents, pick up yourself. Come on now, parents. Look at man. It's every black, the powerful, man, and the boring thing. Parents, pick up yourself. Clap yourself. Clap yourself. Every day, yes. Pick up the father.
Ladies, touch your father. Just give your father a hug. Just hug up your father. If you see a man beside you, hug him up. I know this nobody not hugging up that brown young man over the corner there. A lady sit beside you, sir. Yeah, hug him up. All right. Now, the greatest gift for us today are the graduates.
Give the graduates a round of applause. Two is better than one. And I would like all of these people to come out of my office because I want to see my graduates. Hurry up and give them the water and take away on yourself from them, please. God is good?
All the time.
All the time?
God is good.
You know, I'm not hearing the bass. God is good?
All the time.
All the time?
God is good.
Yeah, man, it's time we step out. We're not too shy. Up on the mouth. Good afternoon. Good morning, graduates.
Morning.
And how are you?
Fine.
You gotta give yourself a big round of applause for looking good. Come on, clap yourself. Yeah, man, I know how much Prime Minister, come on, yourself. How much President, how much doctors, how much lawyers, how much good husband. Give them once again a big round of applause. So, she told you my name is Paul Abrams, but my MC name is Flavor Love. We gonna rock it cool at Norman Garden Auditorium where we have Ananda Marga kindergarten students graduating today. Give them once again a big round of applause. And now I'm going to make welcome because we not plan to stay until the sun hot. So we gonna make welcome by the graduates. Okay, so we have Aima and Athena, yes, and company, yes, give them a big round of applause as they make their way to the stage. When I ask enough to clap the people, they've been asking enough to go back on the hand giant church. Clap, man!
Enjoy our lovely program.
Wonderful, my apology. I see a lady well dressed, you know. I don't know if it's a big fashion show. I'm assuming, I would guess, that she's the guest speaker. I don't know, me just a fast, but just clap her. I don't know if a she, but according to the dressing tells the occasion. Just clap her for me now, please. Me not get the name yet. All right. Now I see where the graduates are coming to sing, "It's a Small World After All." That's the song? All right, graduates, stand. Well, if you clap, let me know, me say that, you don't come here for. Within the next 15 or 20 years, you just go somewhere and say, you know, we did graduate together. Small world. Once again, give them a big round of applause. You may be seated, graduates. You may be seated. On sit down there. You know, Jamaicans, you know, we used to our language. Okay, to introduce the guest speaker, the person that is going to bring a lovely plate of breakfast, something to consume for life. Let us welcome Mrs. Ellis Warburton. Give her a big round of applause.
Hello, So good morning, all. The privilege is mine to welcome our guest speaker. So she is an actress of stage and television, a cultural practitioner, educator, entrepreneur, wife, and mother who cares deeply about our culture and our nation's children. Born in the United Kingdom of Jamaican parents, and I'll repeat, born in the United Kingdom of Jamaican parents. Karen is a past student of Knox College, the Edna Manley College of the Visual and Performing Arts, and holds a postgraduate degree from the University of the West Indies Mona Campus. She is a former board member of the African Caribbean Institute of Jamaica, as well as the Liberty Hall, and a current member of the Women in Maritime, Caribbean, as well as the United Nations Commission, Children of the Mafa Recognition, Justice and Development Project. Mrs. Harriet Wilson serves on the board as Director of Culture, Indigenous Rights and Recognition. Karen remains committed to empowering our youth as we tell our own stories through our own lives' lived reality. I speak of none other than Karen Harriet Wilson. Please clap your hands as she makes her way.
And then they will come to me and say, and when me know you're from? And my remark would be, how me fi know where you know me from? Eh? Me know where me know me from, but me don't know where you know me from. Anyway, I am on the top of the world. Yes, on top of the world, looking down on creation. And it's the only explanation I can find. Yes? With the love that I found ever since you all have been around, that love puts me on the top of the world. God's love puts me and all of us on the top of the world. Today is graduation day. How are you feeling? You have to talk to me too, you know. So it's not just me coming up here and just talking to you. You have to talk to me too. So how are you feeling?
Fine.
Yes, only you feel fine. Who? Let me ask the question again. How are you feeling?
Fine.
Yes, I love it. On top of the world. Yes, man, a son of the field. Because on a big and we all are you parents and teachers, you're looking fine. Yeah, you're looking fine.
So do you.
Yes, mama. So we give thanks. Yes, man. So we give thanks because this we have come to a milestone in our lives. Milestone as graduates. Milestone as parents. Milestone as children. We are here to celebrate. And this is what we use every day to get to this point. What you use at school at your time?
Pencil.
Because you don't start use pen yet. You're supposed to use pencil. And I'm going to tell you why a pencil we use. All some of us big people, we still use pencil. I'm going to use the experience of the pencil to talk to us today. To all a little reasoning. Graduates, you are full of life. This is the stage like the pencil just start sharpening. While you are on top of the world, you're full of life. You are like this. Some of us are like the bottom. When you write it out and it pencil almost done. But you are like the full pencil. You are capable of great things. I want you, because I want you to make a commitment to me, to Didi, to your parents and your teachers today. I want you to say, all right, because you see, like, oh, me an actress, me not like nobody upstage me. When me dep on stage, I mean dep on stage. So make me wait a little bit. Right. So, I want you to say for me today, in front of your parents and in front of your teachers, I am capable of great things. So you're gonna say, like the pencil. Say it after me. Like the pencil. I want you to say it so your parents can hear. So when you start, get your their members say, I saw you say. Like the pencil.
I
am capable of great things.
I am capable of great things.
Again, like the
pencil.
Yes, you hear the bright people, eh? I am capable of great things. But like the pencil, while we are when is your time again? We call upon you. Like the pencil. Yes, man, because they work with me, you know. We work together. We are a team. Like the pencil, while you are capable of great things, you need a hand to guide you so that you can write your best life. And this hand that guides you, remember when you're writing, you have to do something. No, sir? So this hand that use this pencil, that's you, must be God, your parents, and your teachers. Now, when you use the pencil, after a while, you have to stop and you have to sharpen it. Yes? So the pencil has to suffer a little bit. But afterwards, it becomes sharp again and the writing is beautiful. So it is in life. You might have to endure a little pain sometimes. Sometimes you're running up and down out a door and you drop. And you buck your toe and it bleed. Or you scratch your knee. But after your parents and your teachers fix it, it becomes good again. And you are a better person. Because after that, whenever you're running again, you will look. When you are coming, when we were sitting down earlier on, and a number of people came and walked over that blue thing there, and they didn't look, and they bucked them toe. But after that, they became a better person. Because after that, every time you walk over it, you look. Yes? And so you must remember that it will make you into a better person. Another thing I want to share with you about the pencil. You see the pencil? What is on top of the pencil? Thank you. What do you do with a rubber? Thank you. Why these teachers? No, man. Mm-mm. Teachers, clap on yourself. The teachers of Ananda Marga, clap yourself because you realize that. And don't speak to them and say no. These are kids who use their brains. And I'm going to just segue a little bit. This was not in my speech. It just come to me now. If you say it, so me, I will say it. When we born as black people, we're bright. You understand? You hear all them answer the question, we're bright. And when you dunce, you're an anomaly. You're supposed to bright. You're supposed to use your brain. right? And so as we watch them at the full stage of their lives, they understand the importance of the eraser on top of the pencil. The teachers didn't coach them to say, you need to rub it out. They know that them can't rub it out. And so, this means that correcting something you did is not necessarily a bad thing. It helps us on the road to progress. So as you go forward in your life's journey, as you move for your finish basic school, you go primary, high school, university, it is okay to make mistakes. Because as long as you remember that the mistake you made does not define you, because you can rub it out. Make your eraser God, your parents, and your teachers. And so also for parents, I'm saying this to you too. Children did not come with a manual. So most of the times it's trial and error. Even some parents who have six children,